Ironically, this is an abandoned building that's just sitting here, right?
Yeah.
And we got people sleeping just up there and over there too. What could we do with this cave?
Turn it into a hostel.
Yeah?
Turn it into a home.
Yeah.
New Zealand has 1.9 million homes, and on census night 2018, 94,000 of them were empty. That's one in every 20 homes. The census also found 102,000 New Zealanders were experiencing severe housing deprivation. These are people living on the street, constantly couch surfing, and living in houses considered uninhabitable.
Kia ora, so my name is Aaron Hendry. I'm the team leader of the LifeWise Youth Housing Service. I'm also a member of Manaaki Rangatahi, which is a collective that's working to end youth homelessness. When I think of homes standing empty, I think of the people that I know that are suffering. I think about the people that I know that are living on the street tonight, you know. I think of the, you know, over 20 young people that got referred in the last few weeks, and I had to look at their names, read their stories, and recognise that I had to reject all of them because we don't have anywhere for them to go. I think that yeah.
Because we had no place to go, we used to sleep underneath these. I remember one morning.
Under there?
Under here, over in this area. We'd tip the table over so we could sleep under it so no one could see us. Because it was embarrassing, you know, being young. And we didn't want no cops around, so we had to do what we had to do.
How old were you then?
I was about 14.
What was that like? I mean, having to sleep rough or like, you know, break into abandoned buildings to sleep, like.
It was a struggle, bro. Like, honestly, yeah. You know, there were times where I was afraid to sleep at night, so I'd stay awake until day, and then I'd go to sleep at the libraries or at McDonald's. Unfortunately, they shut their McDonald's down because of the amount of homeless people that were going every night. So it's, it was a struggle.
How did that make you feel? Like, you know, you don't have a home, you're in this abandoned building, and you know that, like, you know, people have these homes that are just sitting there vacant, and they're not, you know, living in them, and they're not loving them, and you know, you really needed one. Like, how does that make you feel?
It made me realise how selfish society really is. You know, we have these multi-billionaires sitting up on their castle looking out at a view, and there's like homeless people everywhere. You know, I still think about it every time I walk past the homeless person. I'm like, fuck, bro. You know, there's so much room, but you know, these rich people are taking over.
The most common explanation for New Zealand's 94,000 empty houses are holiday homes. The Coromandel had the highest proportion, with a third of all houses empty on census night. But even in urban centres, there's plenty of vacant properties. Auckland had 17,000 empty houses on census night. There's a range of explanations given for this, such as houses in between tenants or owners, or properties in disrepair. And a concept called property or land banking, where an investor leaves property empty to make profit from capital gains without the work of having tenants.
My name is Sharon Colwick. I'm Executive Officer of the New Zealand Property Investors Federation. There's a lot of reasons why there's empty houses. I've got a house in Auckland at the moment that's empty. I was doing renovations on it, and then I ended up having a flood in it, and now they haven't finished doing the repairs after the flood. That's been empty now for 6 months. So that's counted as an empty house. When the government started working on like the Healthy Home Standard, which is great, when they started working on the Residential Tenancies Act, I said to Chris Farfoy at the time, I said, I understand what you're doing, but don't do it when there's a housing crisis on. Sure, we can slowly start to improve our properties, but what it means if you make rules and regulations, there's a lot of people that have had to leave houses empty. I think there was a developer in Hamilton who had a whole lot of houses, he'd buy them, he'd sit on them for a year or 2 years, wait until he had all the plans done, get it going through council, but he'd have tenants in those houses. He's not doing that anymore. It's too hard to bring them up to the healthy home. So they've got another whole lot of houses there that are sitting empty. If they push it into a certain amount of time, some people say, oh, it's just too hard. My properties are too old. So they decide, no, I'm not going to rent them out anymore.
So you've got your land banking, your homes that aren't up to scratch and need to be revived. What's the third one you mentioned?
Batches.
Yeah. Like, once again, you know, when there's not enough, I think almost all of them we need to address. The solution to this is so much more complex. Even if we fill those homes, we're still going to have people experiencing homelessness because of a range of other inequalities and injustices, right? But I think that from the most simple perspective is if we are struggling with housing and we don't have enough, then that at least, there's a whole layer of people that are in motels right now that could be in a tenancy.
If you had all those millions of dollars, do you think you'd buy heaps of homes and just like have five batches or like...
You know I will, bro. Yeah.
You know. What would you do with those homes?
I would make them into a home for the homeless.
Yeah.
Make them into a home for the, you know, street youth, but, you
so
know.
You get all those houses, but then give them back to the people, right?
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah. Got to, eh, bro? No, we're all going to make it together. That's, you know, that's always been in my mind. We're all going to make it together.
New Zealand's increasing rate of homelessness has coincided with the decline in home ownership rates. More people are having to rent, making property investment more attractive, leaving more houses in the hands of fewer people. Of the homes being rented in 2021, a quarter are owned by people with two or more properties.
Nowadays it's seen as being greedy, and these people saying, well, you know, you shouldn't have, you know, so many houses. And I think, well, everyone needs a place to live, and really it doesn't matter who provides it, and the government can't afford to provide all the houses for all the people. So therefore they really need to concentrate on the lower socioeconomic people that really need, you know, a hand up. They need to concentrate on that, and for the other people that are doing okay for themselves, those houses need to be provided by private landlords.
We do see people that are not able to sustain tenancies because they can't afford it. Or people who are not getting tenancies because the landlord doesn't want the house to have, hey, it's a three-bedroom home, I only want one person to live in it. So no, your partner can't stay or your children can't be here, we're going to have to move you on. You know, so there's people falling out of housing, not because they're doing anything wrong, but because actually the way we're thinking about housing is meaning that we're thinking about it with a business lens rather than a human rights lens. That has led to gross inequalities and injustices in our nation.
So seeing all the whānau who are still out here living rough, like, how does that make you feel?
It makes me want to help them even more. It makes me think twice about how, you know, the system and how it runs. You know, because the system isn't all good, you know. There are some bad things about it, like this.